Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Dmitry Belyanin. On this YouTube channel, I have been discussing the works of world-renowned economists, political theorists, and philosophers, and analyzing current trends. Is social justice possible, and how can it be achieved? How can one remain unbiased in analyzing government policy? John Rawls, an American political philosopher, gave his own answers to these questions in his book A Theory of Justice, published in 1971. According to Bill Clinton, John Rawls is perhaps the greatest political philosopher of the 20th century. He has helped a whole generation of learned Americans revive their faith in democracy itself. In 1999, Bill Clinton rewarded Rawls with the National Humanities Medal. Unlike the utilitarians, who preach the doctrine of the greatest good for the greatest number, Rawls stressed the importance of justice. Justice as fairness is a key concept of the book. According to Rawls, the utility principle is incompatible with social cooperation for the common good. Utilitarians do not take into consideration the distribution of wealth. Thus, a society based on this philosophy may be unfair. Furthermore, utilitarianism does not take into consideration the differences between individuals, implying that utilitarianism is not entirely individualistic. Furthermore, public vote does not determine what is true. Justice as fairness is closer to the ideal, though Rawls admitted that it is also imperfect. Rawls also criticized intuitivism, a philosophical movement that stressed intuition as a key instrument of knowledge of the world. According to Rawls, intuition is insufficient to understand what is fair and what is not. The intuitivistic approach is only part of the methodology that Rawls proposed. Rawls proposed several other methods in his moral theory. According to lexical priority, one principle must be fulfilled first, then the second, third, and so on. A principle is inapplicable until all the previous principles have been fulfilled or their inapplicability has been proven. Under the reflective equilibrium method, moral judgments are used to form moral principles, and any contradictions between judgments and principles must be resolved afterwards to ensure consistent practical guidance. Rawls introduced the original position concept, a hypothetical situation under which all agreements are fair. To decide whether a policy is fair, one should place oneself under a veil of ignorance. If one knows that one is rich, one would be against taxes. If one knows that one is poor, one would support increases in welfare. Under a veil of ignorance, one pretends to be ignorant of one's social position, status, one's own intellect and other abilities, rates, etc., and then tries to decide whether policy is fair. Rawls had formulated two principles of justice which must be fulfilled strictly in the lexical priority that he stated. According to the first principle, all people should have equal rights and freedoms. According to the second principle, any social and economic inequality must benefit all, especially the worst off, and each individual should have access to all jobs and positions. There must be equality of opportunity. Though economic benefits or social welfare may exist without freedom, lexical priority prohibits trading freedom for these benefits. Talent must benefit society as a whole, and undeserved inequality must be compensated. Such compensation makes Rawls's theory egalitarian. An individual is acting fairly if he or she abides by the principles of justice. The right to hold various opinions must be protected. If the people in a society abide by the two principles of justice, they increase each individual's self-esteem, and if one respects oneself, one is more likely to respect others. Envy is less likely to develop in a well-ordered society where these principles are followed. The two principles of justice lead to a constitutional democracy. The priority of the first principle over the second one implies that the decisions of a constitutional assembly take precedence over the legislative process. Regular, honest, and free elections must be held. If private property is allowed, then the government should spend some tax revenue on political parties to protect free discussion from vested business interests. If there is too much inequality in income distribution, political freedom loses its value. Arrangements to provide public goods must be made through the political process, not through the market, to prevent the free rider problem, when some people make use of these goods but do not pay for them. Nevertheless, there is no general answer as to whether socialism or a market economy is better. It depends on the traditions, institutions, and various social trends in the country. Justice implies separation of religion and the state. The freedom of religion may be restricted only if the failure to restrict it may threaten the existing social order. Religious intolerance by the state is proper only if there are reasons to believe that an intolerant sect threatens the freedoms of other sects or religious branches. An intolerant sect has no right to complain about the intolerance of other sects. Any arguments to restrict liberty are derived from liberty itself, though implementing liberties depends on circumstances. Slavery and serfdom may be justified only if the only feasible alternative is even less just. Rawls discusses the concept of civil disobedience, which is the proper response to laws considered unfair under a fair system. Civil disobedience is a public, non-violent, and conscious act of resisting the laws. It can be direct, disobeying the law itself, or indirect, disobeying some other law. A serious violation of the first principle of justice or a gross violation of the second principle of justice can be the basis of civil disobedience. All legal measures must have been tried before then. Though civil disobedience is a violation of the laws, the protesters are still loyal to the legal process, since the protest is non-violent and the protesters are willing to bear all the consequences. The military draft should be used to the extent that it helps secure freedom. According to Rawls, if the country is fighting an unjust war, draft resistance may be justified to stop the conflict. A person is happy if he or she excels in doing what he or she plans. If the plan is rational, then the concept of what is good is rational. Each person needs social connections that increase the individual's confidence and sense of self-esteem. According to Rawls, each person undergoes three stages of moral development. A young child undergoes the stage of authoritarian morality, being unable to judge whether instructions and directions of adults having authority are correct. Next, the morality of association forms. The individual adopts the moral standards of associations to which he or she belongs. Finally, the morality of principles forms. The person becomes loyal to the principles themselves. I have the following questions and comments about the applicability of Rawls's ideas. If the state finances political parties, can it lead to dominance of the few parties that receive the largest contributions? Such dominance may foster stability, yet the opposition must propose serious alternatives, and a large portion of the electorate must understand the differences between the opposition and the ruling party. Otherwise, it is questionable whether state financing of political parties is useful. Also note that Rawls received his medal and recognition under a Democrat as a president. A Republican president could be less supportive of Rawls's ideas, since Republicans tend to support welfare cuts. Also, is it always possible to determine whether a war is just and how? Is it always possible for one to detach oneself from one's wealth, social position, race, and abilities, as a veil of ignorance concept demands? Overall, I recommend this interesting book as an example of a moral theory emphasizing the concepts of both freedom and income equality. I request the viewers of this channel to comment on Rawls's ideas. Put thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. I wish everyone success.